Hey y'all. I'm sorry my energy is kind of low. I just thought I'd share my review very quickly on the beauty treats, which is this one, the All About Glitter palette. You see how pretty it looks? Okay, I'm disappointed because y'all, like, literally what it looks like they did was put glitter literally just like a thin layer right across the top, and then this gunky stuff right below the glitter. I'm like, why would you do that? I mean, granted it was $5.99 for both palettes, but y'all, like, this is for children that don't know about makeup, obviously, like, not even for them, because they wouldn't get the enjoyment out the glitter at all. I did two swatches, and it's, like, so lousy, like, that's one, then that's the other. Like, and then this was one where I kind of, like, scratched the surface real deep. That one, and like, see how it looks? And what is that? And like this one, if you can see the, they literally put glitter across the top where you can see enough of you to pick up the palette, but it's like, well, I already got your money, so. I just wanted to share my thoughts with that because I was like highly disappointed in this palette. I thought I was going to do a tutorial doing something very nice and cool with the little glitter, but I guess I'm going to have to revamp my plans. So yeah, these are going in the trash. My daughter can't even benefit from these, so there's no point in keeping them. I just thought I would share my thoughts on that, because I am highly disappointed. So, I'll be back when I find out exactly what I'm doing. y'all. So this is the finishing look. I really hope you guys enjoy this look. This look is so fun to me on so many levels. I just want to review a few of the products before we end this portion of the video. The Black Radiance Color Perfect Oil Free Liquid Makeup. And I am in the color Cocoa Bean. This foundation, I wasn't too much of a fan of, only because for one, it dries very quick. I guess you can say full coverage or buildable. I don't even think it says whether or not it's full coverage, but it does say color perfect liquid makeup applies smoothly and enhances the natural undertones of the skin. And the color is nice. However, like I said, I was not a fan of how fast this foundation dries. Usually, where is it? My go-to is always the Fit Me Dewy & Smooth foundation, but I decided to give on one video most of Black Radiance products a try in one video and just review them. So I'm not too much of a fan of this foundation. And by the way, Black Radiance, I'm not sure if the sale ended, but they have a 50% off site wide, so you can go and check that out. I think they're doing the Cyber Week, not just Cyber Monday. So I'm not a fan of this. Of course, if you guys have been looking for a palette, of course you guys know I love this. I'm going to be rocking it until they're done selling it. The Black Radiance True Complexion Contour Palette. And I am in the color medium to dark. As you can see, I'm getting on the metal part. So, yes, Black Radiance. Yes. What else did I use of Black Radiance? These two. I did not use on camera, but I have used these before. And these are the Black Radiance Press Powders. Got a lighter color and a darker color. This color is the color Rich Mahogany. Then this color is Creamy Beige. These kind of give me an ashy tone. I don't know if any of you use them, but if so, let me know how you liked it. I don't know. It gives me a lot of flashback when I use these. So, yeah, not a fan. I'm going to keep working with them and the foundation included to see if I'm doing anything wrong. It does say it gives you a matte finish or for your formula. That I do agree with. It is matte free and it is, you can tell it's oil free formula also. So I did not use that on camera, but these are okay. What else did I use in Black Radiance? Oh, they're blush. I am a big fan. of their blush, and this is the Artisan Color Baked Blush, and this is in the color Warm Berry. I absolutely love this blush. It's a little rusty, like I got a few miles on it, but not quite. So that was pretty good. Also, off camera, what I did was with my lipstick, I went in because I wasn't a big fan of just the Cherry Tree matte lipstick. I wasn't a fan of that in just this color 016 in the Me Now pencil. So what I did was once I applied it, I went back with this brown, this 022. And I went in and lined in my lips, and I like that a little better for that tone. Also, I went and set my eyebrows with the NYX Control Free. And this is a eyebrow gel. just to hold my eyebrows in place throughout the day. And did I use anything else off camera? Oh, and I used the Black Radiance Concealer Stick. I am not a fan. If you noticed in the video, I kind of looked a little disappointed. This would not spread. Like, it wasn't spreading at all. So I'm not a fan of this. I'll try to use this for something else. Maybe to contour the nose, maybe. But yeah, I wasn't crazy about this when they were out of the concealer stick, the lighter version. So I wasn't able to get that online because they were out of stock. And was there anything else? And at the end, I just sprayed, set my face with a little bit of the Mario Badescu Rose Water Spray. And I just used that to set my eyes. The glitter, where did I get that? Walmart. They have like a whole pack of glitters in their arts and crafts section. So that's where I got that from. So yeah. Those were the products that I wanted to review. Of course, you already know if you follow me on Instagram, the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subcultural Palette. I am a fan of course, and the Morphe Nightmaster Palette. I am a big fan of, so no complaints there. I love it. I would suggest you to get it if you have not bought it. Put your points together. The Anastasia Subcultural Palette, I got that on sale when they had the Insiders. The Beauty Insiders sell at Sephora, so that's the only reason why I got that. And that is about it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video just as much as I did. I hope you enjoyed the look. If you decide to mimic the look, please feel free to tag me on social media, Facebook and Instagram, and let me know how you enjoyed the look. I love you guys. I thank you so much for your support. And I hope that you all had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Christmas. And of course, I will be posting way before that. But just to get that out of the way, I hope you have a fabulous Christmas. Thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share. Comment below. Give me a thumbs up. And thank you so much.